So one of the main things that holds us back as athletes after we leave the game is this thing called identity crisis. It's not fun. It's something that I went through. It's something that a lot of my counterparts have gone through. If you're an athlete, especially if you're an athlete that's already gone through that transition, you know what I'm talking about. Identity crisis is something that can really affect your relationships. It can affect your business. It can affect your mental health, okay, your finances. It really can affect a lot of different things. If you're somebody who's going through this type of challenge, whether you're an athlete or whether you're somebody who just has some kind of identity crisis after transferring into a different career, stay tuned. I'm going to give you 5 simple but powerful steps that you can take today to overcome that identity crisis in your life. And so if you're new here, welcome. My name is Jelani Jenkins. I'm a former NFL athlete and now mindset coach. And the whole purpose of this channel is to share tips and advice for athletes who are navigating the transition out of sports. And so if you vibe with that, make sure you hit that subscribe button and click the bell to be notified every time I post a new video. To understand identity crisis, you got to understand what identity is first. So identity is how you define yourself. Okay, it's what you believe you are, it's who you believe you are, it's what you believe you are capable of achieving on this earth. And the reason identity is so important is because whoever we believe we are, whoever we say we are, whoever we think we are, we have no choice but to act according to that belief. It's like a very strong psychological mental force that we all deal with as humans, and it's the need to remain consistent with how we define ourselves. The crisis part of it, the identity crisis, is actually when how we define ourselves is now taken away. How we define ourselves now has a lot of conflict. So it's important for athletes, because if we define ourselves as being an athlete, okay, as running down the field or shooting a jump shot, if you only define yourself and believe you are an athlete, then it hurts when it gets taken away. It's challenging. It's painful, okay? And that's when it starts to lead into very, very negative habits, okay? Depression, suicidal thoughts, different vices in order to cope with it, okay? So that is why we're doing this lesson here, and that's why you're gonna learn these 5 simple but powerful steps, okay? So the secret to conquering identity crisis is self-discovery. Self-discovery. Sounds simple, but it's not so simple. And a lot of things hold us back from self-discovery. All right, so now I'm gonna give you 5 steps in order to really deal with it in a practical level. So the first step is free writing. This is how you find your voice. This is how you find your true voice, okay? So you might have heard of a concept called morning pages. You might not have heard of it at all. But essentially what free writing is when you take out a journal and you write, and you just allow whatever comes out to come out, okay? You don't analyze it. You don't say, oh, that didn't sound right. You just keep writing. You keep writing. What happens is you allow whatever is in your subconscious mind to end up on the piece of paper. And after you're able to see that clearly, you're able to now be able to tell a bit more of what your intuition sounds like, what your inner voice sounds like. And that helps you with that crisis to figure out who it is that you truly are. This voice that you see and that you experience when you practice free writing is a voice that's been there all along. It's been there with you through your sports journey. It's going to be there with you till the day you die. Okay, that intuition, that inner voice, is what you're able to find when you practice free writing in your journal. Okay, so simple way to do this: grab a journal or a couple pieces of paper and set a timer for 5 minutes or 10 minutes and just write. If you run out of things to say, say, I don't know what I'm saying. This is stupid. I am tired. Just don't stop writing. Just keep writing. And the more you'll do it, what you'll start to realize is, oh, that's what I sound like. That's what my voice sounds like. Okay. And that'll really help you overcome this identity crisis. Okay. So that's the first step. The second step to overcoming identity crisis is powerful questions. Okay, who am I? What do I want? Who must I become? Those are the 3 most powerful questions when it comes to self-discovery. They're simple, but they're powerful. They hit hard. And you can even start your free writing journal with those prompts. Okay, so who am I? Write. Okay, but those questions, those powerful questions will allow you to come up with powerful answers. And a lot of times when we go through these identity crises, it's because we haven't asked these questions. We're still playing as if we are still this particular identity, even though the sport or whatever it is that helps us to express that identity is no longer there. So asking those powerful questions, you know, what do I want if life were to end tomorrow? Okay, for me, what do I want people saying at my funeral? Ask these powerful questions that really bring up some powerful answers for you to help you through those times of challenging moments once you're in this process. Now, some of you may be asking, how do I know if I'm going through identity crisis? How do I even know if I'm in that position? If I ask you, who are you? How do you feel? Do you feel triggered? Do you feel like it's difficult to come up with the answer? Okay, just get a glimpse of how you feel when someone asks you, who are you? That's usually how you can tell if that question hits home for you and you don't really have like a real answer to answer that by, then that's usually a telltale sign that there are some difficulties with identity. And it's perfectly fine. Like I said, everybody, especially when they transition out of sports, goes through it. So the third step to overcoming identity crisis is focusing on what you really want. If you're worried about something, it's because you're focusing on what you don't want. If you're excited about something, it's because you're focusing on what it is that you do want. So you got to focus on what you want. And in order to do that, you have to know what you want. Okay, that's why the powerful questions are important. That's why it really helps to do the free writing so you can really get an understanding of what it is that your inner voice is saying, where it is that you're being called to. So once you're in that process and you're not understanding how to navigate life after sports, you have to get really clear on what it is that you really want out of life. What is my ultimate vision? What is my dream? And focus on it as much as possible. Focus on it, focus on it, focus on it, and feel good about it. And what happens is, as you start to focus on it and move in that direction, your identity starts to show itself. That new identity, okay? The identity that is after sports starts to really show itself as it moves towards exactly what it wants. So really what you're doing is you're connecting with your intuition and you're allowing that to carry you forward. And as you move forward towards where it is that intuition is carrying you, your identity starts to play itself out. You start to get a really good understanding of who you are outside of sports. The fourth step is what I call mining for gold. Mine for gold. Gold is something that traditionally doesn't lose its value. So when you look back at your career and you look back at your time playing sports, mine for the gold. Mine for the things that do not lose its value when the sports goes away. What are those intangible skill sets? What are those values that you've gained from the sport that you can now use in this next phase? You don't have to completely get rid of the inner athlete. The inner athlete is powerful. It's powerful, it's powerful, it's powerful. And it's something that businesses all over the globe are looking for in their employees, okay, and people to work with and partners. They're looking for that the competitive edge, that championship mindset, that resilience, okay, that teamwork, that ability to focus on a goal and move towards it and win. That is gold. It doesn't lose its value just because the sports went away. So you got to be able to mine for the gold that you experienced in your career. Now, in order to do that, it's going to take gratitude. And what do I mean by that? Gratitude is thankfulness. Okay. It's also acceptance. It's the ability to look back at your career, not with resentment, but with gratitude. To be able to extract the lessons and the gold from it, you have to be thankful for that experience, even if it didn't end the way you wanted it to. I can speak personally from my story. For a long time, I'd say about a year and a half after I stopped playing, I still couldn't watch football on television because it was that traumatic for me. It was very difficult for me to even be in a room when football was playing, and I wasn't able to extract the gold and the lessons to be able to use it in the next phase because I was still going through my own healing. So before you can actually mine for that gold, you have to be able to find gratitude for your experience playing the game, even if it's done. Once you do take those things, you move into your next life, I promise you, you're going to see yourself moving at a whole different level, a whole different frequency from a lot of the people that you are competing against in this professional world and in your personal life. Okay, so fourth step is mine for gold. And then the fifth and final step, embrace fear. Embrace fear, okay? One of the most difficult things about the identity crisis is the fact that we don't know what's next. It's a very uncomfortable space. Once your definition of who you are is no longer there, it's very scary to see what else is there out there, okay? It's uncomfortable. It's out of our comfort zone. And so what happens is once you learn to embrace fear and not have it as a big old wall in front of you, but instead have it behind you and push you forward, then you're able to get comfortable in that uncomfortable space. It may be scary, but you've embraced it. Fear is just false evidence appearing real. Some of you might have heard that before. I didn't make that up. But it's a real thing. Fear is something that is in our mind. Okay, it's like negative goal setting. It's worrying about something that doesn't exist yet. Recognize that it's just a feeling, okay? And it's a feeling that the more you overcome it, the more you are courageous, the more you step into that faith and learn and grow and lean into the uncomfortable spaces, the quicker you'll be able to get over any type of identity crisis. Your identity will start to morph into one that is unstoppable, that is resilient. And you'll pull all of the lessons and the gains and the gold from your time playing sports, and you'll navigate the life after sports as a champion like you are. And so it starts with free writing, powerful questions, focusing on what you really want, mining for gold, and embracing fear. Okay, when you follow those five simple steps, I guarantee you, you're going to overcome that identity crisis and you're going to be moving in this next phase just like you moved on the field, on the court, in the swimming pool, whatever it is you were doing. Okay, you're going to be a champion in this called game of life. And so now that you know how to conquer identity crisis, here are your next steps. If you look below in the description, you're going to find that I left a little treat for you, okay? It's a free guide on how to turn your dreams into reality. Once you download it, you will receive a document with practical steps that you can use immediately to see a transformation in your life. I guarantee you, this is something you don't want to miss. Okay, and it even comes with a bonus guided meditation to speed up the transformation process. Okay, so you'll find that below in the description, and I can't wait to hear how much it helped you in turning your dreams to reality. Okay, and then with all that being said, you are a champion. Always have been, always will be. I'm thankful for you. Thank you for listening, and I'll see you next time. Peace.